All right, so happy New Year's, everybody. Today is New Year's Day 2021, and what better way for me than to spend it farting around and fixing up an old house. That's what I love, so. I haven't been here since Boxing Day, so it feels like I haven't been here in a really, really, really long time. Are we gonna take our hats? Feels like I haven't been here in like a year. Holy shit! Oh wow, does this ever open this up, eh? Yeah,
I like that. The only thing I wish I could have saved is if I this stuff. I wish this kind of stuff was over there. Then these actually work.
His switches?
Yeah.
Oh wow. That's incredible.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of space there with the washer and dryer still in there.
Yeah.
I'll have to come a little bit further away from the wall. I know that there's a dryer duct. I'm thinking we'll try for this one. It has the 4-inch round piece on it, and then it goes to like a 2-inch flat. 2x4 or 2x8-inch flat. Hug the wall, and then top, and it'll have the same thing—a 4-inch thing. We'll just mount on that.
Cool.
Takes up less space.
Cool. I'm good with that. I love this.
To better health and fortune, dreams, lucky numbers, fortunes, horoscopes, games, and first aid.
That's awesome.
1944. Another big thing of hinges. Inside this thing here, we got all sorts of stuff and tools and hooks, and chains.
I had turned it, I had turned it upright a while ago.
That would require probably another.
And then it stayed. There we go. And then it stayed. Well, I'm pretty excited to get back in here tomorrow and do some stuff. Yeah, we'll spend some time together here. Nice job, babe. But maybe my resolution should be that I'm going to start spending a lot more time here. We did have a little bit of a goof on the master bedroom window last week. Chris had accidentally gone ahead and primed this section here where your lower sash raises and lowers. You don't want to do that. You always want to leave that natural so that there's no binding. But it's not a huge deal. It's really easy to fix. It's not the end of the world. He only got in a little bit of shit for that. He's been here, though, and he's made a huge transformation in the basement while I've been at work. So I'm going to take you downstairs, and I'll show you just how much he's gotten accomplished down there. For being a tiny house, this house is very deceiving on the outside. It looks very tiny, but once you get in here and you factor in the basement and the attic, it's actually a very large little house. Yeah, but I hope everybody else is having just an amazing time at this time of year. I know I have been.
Well, I'll take this as the trade since I couldn't see the conjunction.
Yeah, no, it was too cloudy.
Yeah. That was a bummer, but...
That was a there'll be another one in 800 years.
Yeah. This is a gorgeous consolation prize, though.
Maybe this video will be a little bit of a fast forward and a rewind with a little bit of insertions in there. It sounded kind of dirty, didn't it? All right, let's go head down to the basement and I'll show you everything that he's got done down there. I was blown away when I got here today and first came down here. There's been so much more of a transformation, even just from Boxing Day. We're gonna be getting a trailer probably this coming weekend to load up and haul out all of that stuff. Even though I could kind of see the size of the basement when we first came here, the first day that we were here on May 5th for the showing, I'll slide in what it used to look like. Big difference, hey? I could kind of see that though, even with all the items that were in here. I had a pretty good idea of what we were going to be ending up with. This is fantastic. He's done such a great job taking this all apart and making sure that we still have a wonderful section of George's train tracks to keep. Especially after we found his original drawings done decades and decades ago of what his plans were and what he wanted to accomplish. I think it's going to make a beautiful piece, keeping some of his custom work with those drawings. Yeah. So the basement's in great shape. I'm gonna be one of those people, and I'm very sorry, I'm gonna stand on my soapbox right now about old houses. This is not the end of the world when you see the walls in this condition. All it is the brown coat, and it's let go. All these walls really need is just a new coat of brown coat. But Chris has got plans to insulate and drywall down here anyway. That's a very cool piece. I'm gonna have to ask him what that is. This might have something to do with the train set and the controls. Yeah, I'm just kidding. There are a few sections though he said he wants to take care of with some hydraulic cement, so that's his knowledge and his expertise, so I'm gonna let him take care of that. And I'm gonna head upstairs and start getting some paint on some of my windows that are done and ready for that. So I'm gonna start painting these windows here. And I'm gonna slide in something beautiful for those who haven't seen it that happened yesterday on my way to work. Just a moment of beauty and just magic. And it was wonderful. And some of the people that I work with spotted it too. So it was just fantastic. So I'll slide that in there.
Never stop shining your light. Happy New Year's, everybody.
And in honor of the ghost I caught in the basement earlier today, I'm going to listen to that while I do some painting.